All right, let's try to now solve this query with some actual SQL. So we're going to find the number of comments for each photo where the photo ID is less than 3 and the photo has more than 2 comments. So back over here, we will do a select, and I'll get the photo ID and count star. That's going to give me the photo ID, of course, or the ID of the photo, and then the number of comments associated with that photo. Next up, we're going to start from comments. So we're going to take all the different rows of comments. We're then going to apply some initial filtering logic. So out of all the rows we have inside of our comments table, we only want to take a look at the comments where the photo ID is less than 3. So to filter out that initial set of rows, we will make use of the where keyword. We will say where photo ID is less than 3. Then after that, we're going to apply our grouping logic. We want to attempt to group all the remaining rows by their photo IDs. So once again, our database is going to take a look at all the unique values inside the photo ID column and set up some different groups and then assign each row to one of these different groups. So for that, we'll put in a group by photo ID. And now that we've created these groups, we want to filter out some number of them. And we're going to do that filtering by using the having keyword. And once again, anytime you see having, chances are you're going to see an aggregate function used inside of it. So in this case, we only want to take a look at groups where the photo has more than 2 comments. So we're going to count up all the different rows inside of each of these groups by doing a count star. So we'll do a count star. And then we only want to find the photos that have more than 2 comments. So we'll do a count star greater than 2, like so. That's it. That would be our solution. So once again, just one more time. I know this is something I've repeated 3 times. Where is for filtering out individual rows. We then apply the grouping, and then we make use of having to filter out some number of those groups. Let's run this and see how we're doing. All right, there we go. So we are now seeing all the different photos, or some all the different comments, or I should say the number of comments per photo. That's the real phrase I'm going for there, where the photo ID is less than 3 and the photo has more than 2 comments. All right, well, this looks pretty good. Let's take a look at another example of having in the next video.